We lost two of the opening batsmen quickly, but Gautam Gambhir stayed on, taking India to the finals. At the end, it was left to Gautam Gambhir and, of course, Mahendra Singh Dhoni to end the innings, and Gautam Gambhir scoring the final one run needed. It looked difficult at a point. Remember, we have lost the Test series. The first 2020 match also was won by Australia. Gaurav Kalra joining us from the newsroom for that exciting bit of news finally coming in from down under. We've won.
Yes, Karma, it's been a long time coming, but India's finally won a match down under. It's their second T20 game, and it's quite a comfortable win. They've won by 8 wickets against the Australians. Good performance today. Most impressive was the effort they put in the field, and that, I think, really is what stood out for the Indian team today. The fact that they were able to field so well, effected 4 runouts against the Australians, who really were, you know, I think they were a bit surprised with the quality that India put out there. In the end, comfortably chasing down the 130. So a good all-round performance, and that is what will please India. The fact that they put in a strong all-round performance and not just one area of their cricket. They should be very happy with everything. Strong bowling at the top, Praveen Kumar with a couple of wickets, good showing by the spin bowlers, and as I said, the fielders, and then finishing it off well, Gautam Gambhir making a half century, runs also for Virat Kohli and Virendra Sehwag.
Right, Gaurav, as far as the body language is concerned, we saw the World Cup winning team come back in the field today. That kind of commitment, that kind of energy was lacking during the test. How come it's all changed all of a sudden in this second T20?
Well, Karma, I mean, it's very hard to put yourself in the shoes of international sports person and answer that sort of thing. But I think it's quite obvious that this is an Indian team that plays much better in the shorter formats of the game. We must make the distinction here. India lost 4 test matches. That is very different to winning a T20 international, which really is a 3.5 hour game, and it's a hit and a miss. Really, sometimes you win those, sometimes you lose. So while it's very well for supporters around the country to be celebrating this moment, you have to be cautious in realizing the defeat was in the highest form of the game. The victory is in perhaps the one format in which cricket teams win and lose on a regular basis. No one is a consistent winner in this format. But yes, without a doubt, this performance, I think that the more important import of this performance is that India go into a long one-day tri-series now, where they play 4 matches against Australia, 4 against Sri Lanka, and the fact that they are picking up as a unit. They've done well in the field, the 4 runouts, Dhoni was sharp behind the stumps, the catching was good, there's an energy, as you said, the body language very good, and that's a good sign for this very long one-day tri-series. It starts on Sunday and only ends on the 8th of March, so they'll have to be on top of their game for that one.
Well, you were talking about the tri-series, of course, very, very important for the batsmen to come in form, and Gautam Gambhir finally showing some touches, isn't it?
Yes, a very important innings for Gautam Gambhir, because he was struggling throughout the Test series, didn't get too many runs, just that one half century. He's India's premier opener in all formats of the game. There was also a neat little innings from Virendra Sehwag, not his best. But at least he wasn't bowled out by some genuine pace. Today he got out to a spinner. So those are good signs for India. The fact that India's batting lineup chased down 130 right, quite comfortably was a positive sign, Karma. No
we
doubt about
it. We certainly hope that.